Hello, class. Excel is new to some of you, so let's walk through making the chart for the Conoco Tanks lab. Details of what you will be scored on are included in the assignment shown here. Always check to make sure you completed all the parts. There is an example at the end of the assignment of what your product should look like. Here is a copy of the results one group collected. We went over the math in class. Let's use Excel quickly to calculate our flows as follows. Diameter of the tank was measured at 31 inches. Radius is 15.5 inches. Area is equal to pi times radius squared. This yields an area of 754.7 square inches. Let's calculate the volume in 1 inch of the tank to make our calculations easy. Volume is equal to the area times the height. Therefore, volume equals 754.7 square inches times 1 inch, which equals 754.7 cubic inches. There are 1,728 cubic inches in a cubic foot. Dividing 754.7 cubic inches by 1,728 cubic inches per foot yields 0.437 cubic foot of water per inch in the tank. We know that one cubic foot holds 7.5 gallons, so 1 inch in the tank is 0.437 times 7.5, which equals 3.3 gallons per inch. The data collected on Monday is nicely presented here. All we need is the inches that the tank moved, how long it took, and the valve position. The group let the level move 3.3 inches in each case. 3.3 inches times 3.3 gallons per inch yields 10.89 gallons per measure. Enter the data in your spreadsheet. It is best to keep the valve position on the left to make the chart easier. Never enter anything but numbers in your data cells. Put the descriptions in a single cell above the data like shown. This is important. Next, divide the gallons by the time to get the flow rate in gallons per minute. Be careful to calculate the fractional time accurately. For example, 1 minute and 15 seconds is 1.25 minutes, which is 1 plus 15 divided by 60. To make the chart, select the data you want and select Insert from the menu and pick the Scatter Plot button. Be sure to pick Scatter Plot. This is important. Then select the choice with straight lines and points. Stretch the plot to better fit the screen. Select Chart Design from the menu, then select Quick Layout. The top left choice will add the elements you need. Delete the legend by clicking it once and pressing the Delete key. Almost done. Double-click the x-axis. On the right, click the area that looks like a bar chart in the Format Axis menu. Then under Axis Options, make the maximum bounds 100. It sometimes defaults to 120, but this doesn't make sense because there is no such thing as 120% open for a valve. Click the title and give it a good name like Conoco Tanks Valve Flow Curve. In the same way, name the x-axis, the bottom one, something like valve output dash percent. Be sure to put in the units. This is important. Name the y-axis something like flow, gallons per minute. Finally, select the titles and axis and set the font to 12 points by clicking on the item then clicking Home in the menu bar and picking 12 in the font dropdown. Open the snipping tool by typing snip in the search at the bottom left of your screen. Click New and take a snip of your graph. Click File in the snipping tool and save as a JPEG. Be sure to select JPEG in the choice option. This is important. Lastly, save your Excel file, upload both the Excel file and the JPEG to D2L. And we're done.